Will the King of Siam come down to the dock to meet us?
The King himself? I don't think so. Kings don't, as a rule.
I wonder if you know what you're facing, ma'am. An English woman here in the East?
Look, Mother! Look at that boat! Look at the dragon's head in the bow, and the man standing up carrying torches!
That's the royal barge.
Do you suppose that's the king, the man sitting under the gold canopy?
That's Crawley, oh. Sort of a prime minister. The king's right-hand man, you might say.
But do you suppose he's coming out to meet us?
I doubt it. They'll wait till we pass him, then they'll come around our stern. Ma'am, if I might be allowed to offer you a word of warning.
What is it, Captain?
That man has power, and he can use it for you or against you.
Oh, Captain, I don't...
I'm just telling you, ma'am. I think you should know.
Thank you, Captain.
Mother, look! They're closer! Mother, the Prime Minister is naked!
Hush, Louis. That's not a nice word. He's not naked. Well, he's half naked.
Tell him, Brother. Horrible. Don't be, Mother. Father would not have liked us to be afraid, would he?
No, Louis. Father would not have liked us to be afraid.
Mother, does anything ever frighten you?
Sometimes.
What do you do?
I whistle.
Oh, that's why you whistle.
Yes, that's why I whistle. Whenever I feel afraid, I hold my head erect and whistle a happy tune so no one will suspect I'm afraid. While shivering in my shoes, I strike a careless pose and whistle a happy tune so no one ever knows I'm afraid. The result of this deception is very strange to tell, for when I fool the people I fear, I fool myself as well. I whistle a happy tune, and every single time the happiness in the tune convinces me that I'm not afraid. Make believe you're brave, and the trick will take you far. You may be as brave as you make believe you are.
Sir, His Excellency wished to know if you are a lady who will be schoolmistress of royal children.
Yes.
Have you friends in Bangkok?
I know no one in Bangkok at all.
Sir, His Excellency wished to know if you are married.
I am a widow.
What manner of man your deceased husband?
My husband was an officer in Her Majesty's army, and tell your master his business with me is in my capacity of school teacher to the royal children. He has no right to pry into my personal affairs.
I don't think I would, ma'am.
Well, he hasn't, Captain Orton.
Chan mai tonki tonka, mai chai kura kopu.
I don't like that man.
In foreign country, he's best you like everyone until you leave.
Your Excellency, I had no idea you spoke English.
It is not necessary for you to know everything at once. You come with me now, your boxes are carried to palace later.
Oh, no, not to the palace. Who's... I am not living at the palace.
Who say?
The king say. Says. The king has promised me £20 a month and a house of my own.
King do not always remember what he promised. If I tell him he break these promises, I'll make anger in him. I think it is better I make anger in him about larger matters.
But all I want is 10 minutes audience with him.
King very busy now. New Year's celebration is just finishing. Fireworks every night. Cremation of late queen just start.
Oh, you've lost your queen. I'm so sorry. When did she die?
4 years ago. With cremation ceremony comes also fireworks.
And what am I to do in the meantime?
In the meantime, you wait in palace.
Your Excellency, I will teach in the palace, but I must have a house of my own, where I can go at the end of the day when my duties are over.
What do you wish to do in the evening that cannot be done in palace?
How dare you? I am sorry, Your Excellency, but you don't understand. I have come here to work, and I must support myself and my young son, and I shall take nothing less than what has been promised me.
You will tell King this.
I will tell King this.
It will be a very interesting meeting. You come now. You come now, or you can stay on board. I do not care.
If you wish to stay on my ship and return to Singapore.
No, thank you, Captain Orton. Your Excellency, I will go with you. I have made a bargain, and I intend to keep my part of it. But a bargain must be kept on both sides. I shall go with you, Your Excellency.
To the palace?
For the time being. Goodbye, Captain Orton. Thank you very much for everything. Lewis.
Bye, Captain.
Siam? How long?
2 weeks, 3 weeks. She has needed disciplining, Your Majesty. She objects to leaving in palace. Talks about how she say you promise her.
I do not recollect such promise. Tell her I will see her. I will see her in a moment. Who?
Your Majesty, this is Lun Ta, emissary from Court of Burma.
Ah, you, I have a copying of famous Bangkok temple. I have your permission.
He bring you present from Prince of Burma.
Am I to trust a ruler of Burma? Am I to trust this present they send me, or is she a spy?
I am not a spy. My name is Tuktin. You are pleased I speak English? My name is Tuktin.
Is pleased with you. He likes you.
The king is pleased. He is pleased with me, my lord and master. He declares he's pleased with me.
Out of windows.
Yes, Your Majesty, and we have done so. We we have seen New Year's celebrations, royal cremation ceremonies, etc., etc., etc.
Etc.? What is this etc.?
According to the dictionary, it means "and the rest." All the things you have been doing while we have been waiting. Fireworks.
Okay. Best fireworks I ever see at funeral. How you like my acrobats?
Splendid, Your Majesty. Best acrobats I ever see at funeral.
Have children prepare for presentation to school teacher.
How many children have you, Your Majesty?
I have only 67 altogether. I begin very late. But you shall not teach all of them. You shall teach only children of mothers who are in favor with king, which at present are very few. Very few indeed.
Ah,
Lady Tian. Madam, we announce this is Lady Tian, headwife.
There is a happy land far, far away, where saints in glory stand bright, brightest day. In the beginning, God created the heaven and the earth. Missionary.
Oh, a missionary taught you English.
Yes, sir, a missionary.
Lady Tian, you will help Madame Leonore with her school teaching, and she in turn will teach you the better English.
Oh. Your Majesty.
She is grateful to me for my kindness.
Oh, I see. Your Majesty, in our agreement...
You, Dr. Kim, you already speak well the English. She arrived today. She is present to me from Burma Prince.
She is a present?
Madame, you have English books I could read?
Of course I have.
I wish most to read a book called The Small House of Uncle Thomas. It is written by American lady, Harriet Beecher Stowe.
A woman has written a book?
Oh, a wonderful book, Your Majesty. An American book, all about slavery.
Ha! Huh? President Lincoln against slavery, no? Me too! Slavery, very bad thing. I think you shall teach my wives, too. Those wives who are in royal favor.
I shall be most happy to teach your wives, even though that was not part of our agreement. Oh, speaking of our agreement reminds me, there is one little matter about my house.
Oh, so I will allow you to help me in my foreign correspondence.
Yes, Your Majesty, I don't think you understand. Your Majesty, I don't think you understand about my house.
House? House? What is this about house?
I want my house, Your Majesty. The house you promised me.
You shall live in palace. You teach in palace, you shall live in palace. If you do not live in palace, you do not teach, and you go wherever you please. I do not care. You understand this?
Yes, Your Majesty. But if these are the only terms on which I am allowed to remain...
Enough! I have no more time to talk. Talk to other women. My women. My wives.
Tulalongkorn, heir to throne. I would be happy if you would teach children.
I would like to, very much. I have come all the way from Singapore to do so, but really, under these conditions...
It would be very great help to all here, sir.
Lady Chiang, why do you call me sir?
Because you're scientific, not lowly like a woman.
Do all of you think women are more lowly than men? angry already. That lovely girl, he said she was a present.
From Prince of Burma. I think she loves another man. If so, she will not see other man again.
Poor child.
Oh no, sir. She is foolish child. To wish for another man when she has king.
But you can't help wishing for a man if he is the man you want.
It is strange for a school teacher to talk so romantic.
Romantic. I suppose I am. I was very much in love with my late husband, Tom.
Tom.
Once a woman has loved like that, she understands all other women who are in love. And she's on their side, too, even if she is just a school teacher.
Tom!
Yes, Tom.
He was pretty in face.
Oh, dear, yes, he was very pretty in face. When I think of Tom, I think about a night when the earth smelled of summer and the sky was streaked with white, and the soft mist of England was sleeping on a hill. I remember this, and I always will. There are new lovers now on the same silent hill, looking on the same. And I know Tom and I are a part of them all, and they're all a part of Tom and me. Hello, young lovers, whoever you are, I hope your troubles are few. All my good wishes go with you tonight. I've been in love like you. Be brave, young lovers, and follow your star. Be brave and faithful and true. Cling very close to each other.
Princesses. What was not, Now I am a man. The world have changed a lot. Some things nearly so, others nearly not. There are times I almost think I am not sure of what I absolutely know. Very often by confusion, in conclusion I concluded long ago. In my head are many facts that as a student I have studied to procure. In my head are many facts of which I wish I was more certain. I was sure. Is it puzzled what to tell a growing son? What, for instance, shall I say to him of will? Shall I educate him on the ancient lines? Shall I tell the boy as far as he is able to respect his wives and love his concubines? Shall I tell him everyone is like the other? And the better one of two is really neither. If I tell him this, I think he won't believe it. And I nearly think I don't believe it either. When my father was a king, he was a king who knew exactly what he knew. And his brain was not a thing forever swinging to and fro and fro and to. Shall I then be like my father and be willfully unmovable and strong? Or is better to be right? Or am I right when I believe I may be wrong? Shall I join with other nations in alliance? If a lies are weak, am I not best alone? If a lies are strong with power to protect me, might they not protect me out of all I own? Is a danger to be trusting one another? One will seldom want to do what other wishes. But unless someday somebody trusts somebody, there'll be nothing left on earth excepting fishes. There are times I almost think nobody's sure of what they absolutely know. Everybody find confusion in conclusion he concluded long ago. And it puzzles me to learn that though a man may be in doubt of what he know, very quickly will he fight, he'll fight to prove that what he does not know. Etc., etc., and so forth. If my Lord in heaven pull us away, every day I try to live another day. If my Lord in heaven pull us away, every day I do my best for one more day. But is it puzzlement?
Show how he destroy all who fight him. Greed, Burma. Here is King of Burma. No clothes mean how poor is King of Burma.
Thank you, Lady Chiang. Will you take my place? The map you have been looking at is an old one. Today we have a surprise. Louis, will you pull that down for me? A new map has just arrived from England. It is a present to us from His Majesty, your King.
The Lord of Light.
Yes, the Lord of Light.
The White is Siam.
Siam, not so small.
Hush, Your Highness.
Wait, let me show you England. See, England is even smaller than Siam.
Before I came here, Siam was to me like that little white spot. Now I have lived here for more than a year. I have met the people of Siam, and I am beginning to understand them.
You like us?
I like you very much indeed. There's a very ancient saying, but a true and honest thought, that if you become a teacher, by your pupils you'll be taught. As a teacher, I've been learning. You'll forgive me if I boast. And I've now become an expert on the subject I like most. Getting to know you. Getting to know you. Getting to know all about you. Getting to like you. Getting to hope you like me. Getting to know you, putting it my way, but nicely. You are precisely my cup of tea. Getting to know you, getting to be free and easy. When I am with you, getting to know what to say. Haven't you noticed? Suddenly I'm bright and breezy because of all the beautiful and new things I'm learning about you day by day. Getting to know you, getting to know all about you, getting to like you, getting to hold you like me. change into small white spots that look like lace. This is called snow.
Snow? Spots of lace.
Yes, Your Highness. The water freezes on the way down from the sky.
And the raindrops are into little stars.
Yes, Your Highness. Some are shaped like little stars.
There's not a word of truth in it.
I do not believe such thing as snow.
And I do not believe Siam is so big and other countries so big.
Siam and his country in the world! Yeah!
What? How can schoolroom be so unscientific?
Your Majesty, we have had a little misunderstanding. I was describing snow to them, and they refused to believe there was such a thing. Snow?
Ah, yes, from mountaintop.
From the sky.
From sky to mountaintop.
Sire, please, how does it come down from the sky?
Like this.
Thank you, sire.
I have seen pictures. Switzerland, land all white with snow.
That's right, Your Majesty.
Who does not believe this?
Well, after all, they have never seen it.
Never seen? If they will know only what they see, why do we have schoolroom? Rise. Do not ever let me hear of not believing school teacher, whom I have bring here at great expense. £20. Each month, £20 sterling. Children must learn. Teacher must teach. Not waste time instructing children in silly English song, home sweet house. To remind me of breaking promises I never made, etc., etc., etc.
You did promise me a house, Your Majesty. A brick residence adjoining the royal palace. Those were your words in your letter.
I do not remember such words.
I remember them.
I will do remembering. Who is king here? I remind you, so you remember that. I do not know of any promises. I do not know anything except that you are my servant.
Oh, no, Your Majesty.
Whoa, what? I say, you are my servant.
No, Your Majesty. Indeed, I am not your servant.
I would see your mother as bad man.
Oh, you would, but you? I'd say your father has no man.
Louis, if you do not give me the house you promised me, I shall return to England.
No,
please do not let her go away.
I let her do nothing that is not my pleasure. It is my pleasure. You stay here. You stay here in palace, in palace.
No, Your Majesty.
I give you servants. I give you bigger room.
That is not the point, Your Majesty.
Why wish you to leave these children, all whom loving you so extraordinarily?
I do not wish to leave them. I love them too, quite extraordinarily. But I cannot stay in a country where a promise has no meaning.
I will hear no more about this promise.
A land where there is talk of honor, and a wish for Siam to take her place among the modern nations of the world, where there is talk of great changes, but where everything still remains according to the wishes of the king.
You will say no more. No more!
I will say no more because I have no more to say.
Hold it out! So big a world. Siam very small. England very small. All people very small. No man big enough for to be alone. No man big enough. King. King different. King need no one. Nobody at all! I think
Anna was our only friend.
We cannot be seen talking like this. Anyone could come in. Pretend to wait for her.
If only we could stop pretending. We kiss in the shadow. We hide from the moon. Our meetings are few and over too soon. We speak in a whisper, afraid to be when people are near, we speak not a word. Alone in our secret, together we sigh for one smiling day to be free. To kiss in the sun. Say to the sky, behold and believe what you see. Behold now, my lover loves me. When can we meet? When?
It is not possible. We cannot meet alone ever. Not ever.
Oh!
your servant. Indeed, I'm not your servant. Although you give me less than servant's pay, I'm a free and independent employee. Because I'm a woman, you think like every woman, I have to be a slave, a concubine. You conceited, self-indulgent, libertine, libertine. How I wish I'd called him that, right to his face. Libertine. And while we're on the subject, sire, there are certain goings on around this place that I wish to tell you I do not admire. I do not like polygamy or even moderate bigamy. I realize that in your eyes that clearly makes a prigamy. But I am from a civilized land called Wales, where men like you are kept in county jails. In your pursuit of pleasure, you have mistresses who treasure you. They have no ken of other men beside whom they can measure you. A flock of sheep and you the only ram. No wonder you're the wonder of Siam. Oh, I'm really rather glad I didn't say that. Women right there, and the children, I'll not forget the children, no matter where I go, I'll always see those little faces looking up at me.
More distressing thing. Our agents in Singapore have found letters to British government from certain people whose greedy eyes are on Siam. describe King as barbarian and suggest making Siam protectorate.
Oh, that is outrageous. He has many things I do not like, but he is not a barbarian.
Then you will help him.
You mean advise him?
It must not sound like advice. King cannot take advice, and if you go to him, he will not bring up subject. You must bring it up.
I cannot go to him. It is against all my principles, certainly not without his having asked for me.
He wished to be new blood king with Western ideas, but it is hard for him, Mrs. Anna. And there is something else. Princess Taptim, I do not tell King this for his sake. This I will deal with in my own way. But for these other things, he need help, Mrs. Anna.
He has you.
I am not equal to his special needs. He could be a great man, but he needs a special help. He needs you.
Lady Tian, please don't think I'm just being stubborn. But I cannot go to him, I will not.
What more can I say to you? This is a man who thinks with his heart. His heart is not always wise. This is a man who stumbles and falls, but this is a man who tries. This is a man you forgive and forgive, and help and protect as long as you. Many things, but this
Majesty. Your Majesty. Your Majesty's reading the Bible.
Mrs. Anna. I think your Moses shall have been a fool.
Moses?
Moses. Here it stands written by him that the world was created in 6 days. You know and I know it took many ages to create world. I think he shall have been a fool to have written so. What is your opinion?
Your Majesty, the Bible was not written by men of science, but by men of faith. This was their explanation of the miracle of creation, which is the same miracle, whether it took 6 days or many centuries.
You have come to apologize?
I am sorry, Your Majesty.
Good, you apologize. I accept.
Your Majesty, nothing that has been said can alter the fact that in my country a promise...
Silence! Tell me about President Lincoln of America. Shall Mr. Lincoln be winning this war he is fighting at present? Does he have enough guns and elephants for transporting same?
I don't think they have elephants in America, Your Majesty.
No elephants? Then I shall send him some. Write letter to Mr. Lincoln.
Now?
Now, when else? Now is always best time.
Very well, Your Majesty.
From Brahmaha Mongkut, by the blessing of the highest super agency in the world of the whole universe, the King of Siam. Sovereign of all tributary countries, adjacent and around in every direction, etc., etc., etc. Do you not have any respect for me? Why do you stand over my head? I cannot stand all the time. And in this country, no head shall be higher than king's. From now on in presence, you shall so conduct yourself like all other subjects.
You mean on the floor? I am sorry, Your Majesty. I shall try very hard not to let my head be as high as Your Majesty's, but I simply cannot grovel on the floor. I couldn't possibly work that way, or think.
You are a very difficult woman. But you shall observe care. Head shall never be higher than mine. If I shall sit, you shall sit. If I shall kneel, you shall kneel, etc., etc., etc.
Very well, Your Majesty.
Is promise?
Is promise.
Good? Who is Royal Presidency of the United States in America, Abraham Lincoln, etc.? You fix up. It has occurred to us. It has occurred to us. It has occurred to us that if several pairs of young male elephants were turned loose in forests of America, after a while they would increase.
Your Majesty, just male elephants.
You put in details. Tonight my mind is on other matters, very important matters.
Anything you want to discuss with me?
Why should I discuss important matters with a woman?
Very well, Your Majesty. Then I shall go back to my room. May I say good night?
Good night!
Majesty.
What?
I was wondering when the boat arrived from Singapore yesterday.
Singapore? Huh?
Was there any news from abroad?
News? Yes, there are news. They call me barbarian.
Who?
Certain parties would wish to use this as excuse to steal my country. Suppose you are Queen Victoria and somebody tell you King of Siam is barbarian. Do you believe?
Well, I...
You will. You will believe that I am barbarian because there is no one to speak otherwise.
But this is a lie.
It is a false lie.
What have you decided to do about it? You guess. Sending a big lie about me to England. I think I should do my best to send the truth to England. Is that what you've decided to do, Your Majesty?
Yes, that is what I have decided to do. But how? You guess how I shall do this.
Well, my guess would be that when Sir Edward Ramsay arrives here...
Ramsay?
The British diplomat.
Yes, on way from Singapore. When he is here, I shall take opportunity of expressing my opinion of English thieves who wish to steal Siam. I shall show him who is barbarian. What is this face you put on?
Well, Your Majesty, my guess would be that you will not fight with Sir Edward.
I will not?
No. You will entertain him in a particularly grand manner, then he will return to England and report to the Queen that you are not a barbarian.
Naturally! Naturally, that is what I shall have intended to do!
This is the only way to get the better of the British. Stand up to them, put your best foot forward. Oh, this is just an expression, Your Majesty. It means a dress up in your best clothes. Show them your most intelligent men, your most beautiful women. Edward admires beautiful women.
Edward? You call him this?
We are old friends. I knew him in Bombay before I was married.
But shall it be proper for the British dignitaries to see my women with no shoes on their feet? Shall it be proper for them to put their best bare feet forward? No! Sir Ramsay will go back and tell Queen Victoria I am barbarian. Why do you not think of this?
We shall dress them up. European fashion.
You mean dress them in dresses?
How many women can I have to sew for me?
All women in kingdom. How many dresses?
Oh, that depends on how many ladies are chosen by Your Majesty.
You shall tell me which of my women are most like Europeans who are dressing like him. Wake up! Everybody! Wives, etc., etc., etc. I shall command Chinese artists to paint their faces very pale, and you shall educate them in European custom and manner for presentation.
I wonder how much time we shall have.
So Ramsay's gunboat last reported off Songkla. How long he take depends on how many ports he call into. Let us say we have 1 week.
1 week? Your Majesty, 1 week?
In this time, whole world was created, Moses said. Are there any details I do not think of so far?
You must give them a dinner. A fine dinner, a European dinner.
I was going to.
And a ball with music.
Music? And dancing?
Yes, Your Majesty, and dancing.
Why do you not think of dancing?
It is an inspired idea, Your Majesty. And we can give them a play. Tupton has written a version of Uncle Tom's Cabin.
But we shall give them theatrical performance. We shall show them who is barbarian. Line up. Lady Tiara, on Saturday next at 9 o'clock, post-meridian, we shall give fine dinner. European dinner. You are to instruct steward during week. He shall make eminent European dishes for tasting. I shall taste, and school teacher shall taste. You say who is most like European lady for dressing like saying. You must make tablecloth of finest white silk for a very long table. Also instruct court musicians to learn music of Europe for dancing, etc. Well, what? Am I to be annoyed by children at this moment? Who? Mrs. Anna, we must be more scientific with children. For the next week, the men and women of my kingdom will work without sleeping until all is ready. And for what is not done, each man and woman shall be beaten 100 strokes. Everyone must know this, Lady Tiram. Tell this to everybody. Above all, I must not be worried by anything. Fireworks at this time in the morning. No one may order fireworks but me.
Your Majesty, the British, the gunboat, they attack. No, they salute, and we answer with fireworks. It's Sir Edward Ramsay and his party.
Now?
They must have come direct from Songkhla. No stops.
No stops, Your Majesty.
Tell them to go back. We are not ready.
Not ready, Your Majesty.
You do not know. You do not know. I had planned best idea I ever get.
Still, we do it, Your Majesty. You can do it.
When English arrive, we shall put them to bed. Tomorrow morning, we shall send them on sightseeing trip.
We shall start now, this minute. Work, work. We've only 18 hours, but I shall do it somehow.
I shall do it. You shall help me.
Yes, Your Majesty.
No one may sleep tonight or tomorrow. We shall work even when the sun shines in the middle of the day. We shall... Ah, priests, come, come. First, we ask help from Buddha. Bow to him. Bow, bow, bow. Bow.
how you look. Oh, very pretty. Now turn around, get ready for your curtsy. Oh, oh my goodness gracious!
What shall be trouble now?
I forgot. They have practically no undergarments.
Undergarments? Of what importance are undergarments at this time?
Of great importance, Your Majesty.
Are you wearing undergarments?
Of course, Your Majesty.
That a woman has no legs is useless to pretend. Wherefore then, swollen skirt?
The wide skirt is symbolic. It is the circle within which a female is protected.
This is necessary? Englishmen are so aggressive, I did not know.
I said it was symbolic.
These undergarments, they are devised in symbolic and ornamental manner, yes?
Sometimes.
This is what you are going to wear?
Why, yes, Your Majesty. Do you like it?
This is what all the other visiting ladies shall look like?
Most of them, I believe.
You are certain this is customary, etc., etc., etc.?
Yes, I am certain this is customary. What is so extraordinary about bare shoulders? Why, your own ladies are...
Yes, but is different. They do not wear so many coverings up on other parts of body, and therefore...
Therefore, what?
Is different.
I am sorry, His Majesty does not approve.
I do not say I do not approve, but I do say...
Your Majesty, the English, they are in palace.
They will eat us! They will eat us!
They will do nothing of the kind, ladies.
Mrs. Anna, here will shall be a list of subjects you shall try to bring up for talk. On such subjects, I am very brilliant and will make great impression. You begin with Moses.
Now remember, Your Majesty, Courtright is
the...
Custom of spying glass.
Oh, my monocle! Is that what frightened them? Hello, Anna, my dear.
Who, who, who?
Your Majesty, may I present Sir Edward Ramsay?
Your Majesty?
I am sorry, sir. My ladies have not given good impression.
On the contrary, Your Majesty, I've never received so good an impression. You have most attractive pupils, Anna.
Tomorrow you must meet my younger pupils, His Majesty's children.
I shall be delighted. How many children have you, Your Majesty?
77 now. But I am not married very long. Next month expecting 3 more.
No problem at all about finding an heir to the throne, is there? I should apologize for wandering in this room.
Oh,
but...
I'm so happy you decided to visit us. To visit His Majesty, I mean, of course.
It was your postscript to His Majesty's letter that really brought me here.
Postscript?
His Majesty was most happy when you decided to accept his invitation, weren't you, Your Majesty?
I was happy. Your Majesty. Wait.
Your Majesty, dinner is about to be served, but I would first like to present your guest to you in the reception room.
Ha! Dinner, dinner, dinner!
You have met.
Your Excellency.
Anna, my dear. You're looking lovelier than ever.
Thank you, Edward.
That's a job you're doing. People who can help, that's it, isn't it? Extraordinary how people get attached. People need one. You hear that? You know, we danced a bit once. Bombay. Still dance?
Not very often.
You should.
don't ever get homesick?
No, Edward, I told you. I have nothing there. No one.
Hannah, you remember that I once asked you to marry me? Before Tom came along.
Dear Edward.
Dancing after dinner!
Sorry, sir, I started talking over old times.
It was my impression Mrs. Anna would be of help for seating of guests at dinner table.
In that case, we'd better be going in, Anna.
Yes, better be going in. Anna?
Made an interesting observation the other day about Moses.
I have dreamed.
both here. I ran out to warn you. Oh, I do think you're being reckless.
Yes, I will go. I must say goodbye now, Mrs. Anna.
Gracious! Anyone would think she never expected to see me again.
Mrs. Anna, we are leaving tonight.
Leaving? How?
Do not ask me how. It is better you do not know. We shall never forget you, Mrs. Anna. Never.
God bless you both. I know how it feels to have wings on your heels and to fly down a street in a trance. You fly down a street on the chance that you meet, and you meet not really by chance.
Happy people!
will come to him and thank him personally for the saving of Eliza and baby. And so she dies and go to arms of Buddha.
Goodbye, Anna, my dear. It was lovely to see you again.
Goodbye, Edward. Well, Your Majesty.
It is all over.
Oh, may I remove my shawl? It is a very hot night. I am so pleased about everything.
I am aware of your interest. I wish to say, you have been of great help to me in this endeavor. I wish to make gift. I have hope you will accept. Put it on finger. Put it on, put it on. When one does not know what to say, it is the time to be silent. A white elephant has been discovered in Forest of Ayuta.
You consider this a good omen, don't you?
Yes. Everything going well with us.
Everything going well with us.
Whoa!
It is I, Your Majesty.
Wait, wait, wait! Coming, coming.
Your Majesty.
Well, well, well.
Secret police are here. They would make report to you.
You will wait here.
Secret police.
Your finger shines.
Oh, yes, the king. I did not know what to say. Women in my country don't accept such gifts from men. Of course, he is the king. Actually, it places me in rather an embarrassing position. I was intending to ask him for a rise in my salary, and now...
And now, it will be difficult to ask.
Yes, very. I don't suppose you would speak to him for me. About my rise in salary, I mean.
I think I shall do this for you. Because this is a strange world in which men and women can be very blind about things nearest to them.
Thank you, Your Excellency. I don't understand what you mean.
No, but that does not matter. And I do not think he will raise his salary anyway.
Ah! Good news and bad news come together. You will please stay up all night until we have further report on item of top 10.
I had intended to do so, Your Majesty.
Perhaps I had better go, too.
No, no, no. I wish to talk with you.
Is there something wrong with top 10?
I do not know. Nor do I consider this the most important thing I must tell you. It is of greater interest that the English think highly of me. Secret police have served coffee after dinner and listen to what they talk and report conversation to me.
You have been spying on your guests.
How else can you find the truth? It appears I have made excellent impression. It is clear they do not think me barbaric.
This is what you intended to prove.
What we intended to prove. Top 10.
What about her?
She is missing from Paris. You know something of this.
The last time I saw her, she was at the theater pavilion.
That is the last time anyone has seen her. She never speaks to you of running away.
I knew she was unhappy.
Why unhappy? She is in palace of king. What greater honor for a young girl than to be in palace of king?
Your Majesty, if Top 10 is caught, shall she be punished?
Naturally. What would you do if you were king, like me?
I believe I would give her a chance to explain. I think I would try not to be too harsh. Your Majesty, of what interest to you is one girl like Top 10? She is just another woman, as a bowl of rice is just another bowl of rice, no different from any other bowl of rice.
Now you understand about women. But British poets.
Your Majesty has been reading poetry.
Out of curiosity over strange ideas about love, etc., etc. I tell you, this poetry is nonsense and a silly complication of a pleasant simplicity. A woman is a female who is human, designed for pleasing man, the human male. A human male is pleased by many women, and all the rest you hear is fairy tale.
Then tell me how this fairy tale began, sir. Cannot call it just a poet's trick. Explain to me why many men are faithful and true to one wife only.
They are sick.
But you do expect women to be faithful.
Naturally.
Why naturally?
Because it is natural. It is like old Siamese rhyme. A girl must be like a blossom, with honey for just one man. A man must live like honeybee, and gather all he can. To fly from blossom to blossom, a honeybee must be free. But blossom must not ever fly from me to be, to be.
You consider this sensible poetry, Your Majesty?
Certainly. But listen to this from your own poet, Alfred Tennyson. Now folds the lily all her sweetness up and slips into the bosom of the lake. So fold thyself, my dearest thou, and slip into my bosom. English girls are so acrobatic.
Your Majesty, I don't know if I can ever make it clear to you. We do not look on women as just human females. They are
Why, take yourself, for example. You are not just a human male.
I am king.
Exactly. So every man is a king and every woman a queen when they love one another.
This is a sickly idea.
It is a beautiful idea. We are brought up on it, of course. And a young girl at her first dance.
Young girls? They dance too, like I see tonight? In arms of men, not their husbands?
Why, yes.
I would not permit.
It's very exciting when you're young and you're sitting in a small gilt chair, your eyes cast down, terrified you'll be a wallflower. Suddenly, you see two black shoes, a white waistcoat, a face, and it speaks. We've just been introduced. I do not know you well, but when the music started, something drew me to your side. So many men and girls are in each other's arms. It made me think we might be similarly occupied. Shall we dance? On a bright cloud of music, shall we fly? Shall we dance? Shall we then say goodnight and mean goodbye? Or perchance, when the last little star has left the sky, shall we still be together with our arms around each other? And shall you be my new romance? On the clear understanding that this kind of shall we dance? Shall we dance? Shall we dance?
Why you stop? You dance pretty good, man.
Your Majesty, I didn't realize. After all, a girl in my country would never dance while a man was looking on.
But she will dance with strange man, holding hands, etc., etc.
Always a strange man, sometimes a very good friend.
Good. We dance together. You show me. You teach, you teach, you teach.
It's very simple, the polka. It goes 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3 and 1, 2, 3 and. Shall we dance?
1, 2, 3 and.
On a bright cloud of music, shall we fly?
1, 2, 3 and.
Shall we dance?
1, 2, 3 and.
Shall we then say goodnight and mean goodbye?
1, 2, 3 and all the chance. When the last little star have leave the sky.
Shall we still be together with our arms around each other? And shall you be my new
romance?
On the clear understanding that this kind of thing can happen.
Shall we dance? Shall we dance? Shall we dance? 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. What is wrong? I know, I forget. And this time I remember. And 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and.
Splendid, Your Majesty!
Splendid! 1, 2, 3. You throw me off count. And 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, and. But this is not right.
Yes, it is. You were doing wonderfully.
No, no, no. He's not right. Not the way I see Europeans dancing tonight.
Yes, it was just like that.
No. We're not holding two hands like this.
No. As a matter of fact.
It was
him. Where is she?
Secret police are questioning her.
Now that you have found her, what will you do with her?
I will do what is usually done in such an event.
What is that?
When it happens, you will know.
Mrs. Anna! Mrs. Anna! Do not let her leave me!
She was found on Chinese sailing ship. See, she was disguised as a religious student.
Who gave you this role?
Who? It is believed she was running away with a man who bring her here from Burma.
Dishonor! Dishonor!
He was not found on board.
Where is this man?
I do not know.
You will tell us where we will find him. You will tell us!
I do not know!
It is believed you were lovers with this man.
I was not lovers with this man!
Dishonor! We will soon have truth of this man. Oi!
No!
Stop it! Do you hear me? Stop it!
It would be better if you understand at once. This matter does not concern you.
But it does, it does. Not only because of her, but even more because of you.
You waste my time.
She's only a child. She was running away because she was unhappy. Can't you understand that? Oh, Your Majesty, I beg of you, please, don't throw away everything you've done. This girl hurt your vanity. She didn't hurt your heart. You haven't got a heart. You've never loved anyone. You never will.
I show you! Get away!
Oh, I cannot believe you're going to do this dreadful thing.
You do not believe her. Maybe you will believe when you hear her screaming as you run down the hall.
I am not going to run down the hall. I am going to stand here and watch you.
Hold this girl!
No!
I do this all myself!
You are a barbarian!
Down there now! Am I king or am I not king? How am I to be cuckolded in my own palace? And I can take orders from English schoolteacher?
Orders.
Silence! I am king! As I was born to be, designed to be governed in my way, not English way, not French way, not Chinese way, my way. Barbarian, you say, there is no barbarian worse than a weak king. And I am strong, can you hear? Strong!
Ah, Captain Autumn, your boat is docked.
just in time. We are welcoming Elephant Prince to Bangkok.
A white elephant, eh? That's it. I just passed a young prince a little while ago. Where's the king? I didn't see him in the procession.
King is ill. Very ill. He's been ill for many months.
Say goodbye. Captain Orton must sail with the tide.
I did not come only to say goodbye, Mrs. Anna. I come for one who must see you. You must go to him. When he heard you were sailing, he started to write this letter. All day he has been writing. It was very difficult for him, madame. Very difficult. And he has commanded that I bring it to you.
Please read to all of us. I will hear what my father has said.
While I am lying here, I think perhaps I die. This heart which you say I have not got is a matter of concern. It occurs to me that there shall be nothing wrong that men shall die. For all that shall matter about man is that he shall have tried his utmost best. But I do not wish to die without saying this gratitude, etc., etc. I think it is strange that a woman shall have been most earnest help of all. But Mrs. Anna, you must remember that you have been a very difficult woman, and much more difficult than generality. And I must go to him.
Thank you.
make you better friends?
I suppose so. We can't hurt each other anymore.
I didn't know he hurt you.
When two people are as different as we are, they're almost bound to hurt each other.
He always frightens me.
Oh, Louis, I wish you had known him better. You could have been great friends in some ways. He was just as young as you.
Was he as good a king as he could have been?
I don't know if any man has ever been as good a king as he could have been. But this one tried. He tried very hard.
You really like him, don't you, Mother?
Yes, Louis. I like him very much. Very much indeed.
I do not see you, Mrs. Anna. And now I die.
Oh, no, Your Majesty.
This is not scientific, Mrs. Anna. I know if I die or do not die. You are leaving Siena. When?
Very soon. In fact, I can only stay a few minutes more.
You are glad for this. People of Siena, royal children, etc., are not glad and are in great affliction of your departure.
I shall miss them.
You shall miss them. But you shall be leaving. I too am leaving, but I am not walking onto a boat with my own feet, of my own free will. I am just leaving. Why is your head above mine? I am not afraid of that which is happening to me. You teach Julalongkorn. Julalongkorn, teach me. Make believe you brave is good idea, always.
You are brave, Your Majesty. You are very brave.
Here is something belonging to you. Put it on. Put it on, put it on, put it on. Please wear it, always. Ah, my children. Tell them to come here. Good evening, my children.
Good evening, my father. Please accept me to come here.
Hush, children. Did you come to see your father? Oh, Mrs. Anna.
It is all right, Lady Tian. It is suitable. Was it not said to me that someone had written farewell letter to Mrs. Anna?
Princess Yin Yao Lak has composed letter to Mrs. Anna. She cannot write. She only make up words.
Speak like her now. Say it, say it, say it.
Dear friend and teacher, my goodness gracious, do not go away. We are in great need of you. We are like one blind. Do not let us fall down in darkness. Continue good and sincere concern to us and lead us in the right road. Your loving
hush, children. When you are afraid, make believe you break. You show them how you do. You teach them. Let it be the last thing you teach.
Yes, teach us.
When ever I feel afraid.
Said there shall be no bowing for showing of respect of king. It has been said by one who has betrayed.